Today we're going to talk about steps to be a consistently more profitable trader. Stay tuned, traders. We'll be right back. G'day, traders. I'm Stacey Burke from Stacey Burke Trading. Today we're going to be talking about steps that will help you potentially become a consistently more profitable trader. I just listened to a great interview on Chat with Traders with Mike Bellafori from SMB Capital. If you're not familiar with Mike, I suggest you tune in to his YouTube channel at SMB Capital or Chat with Traders, Aaron Fifield, some incredible interviews. But Mike Bellafori is the author of the book One Good Trade and also The Playbook. They run SMB Capital, which is a proprietary trading prop firm in New York City. And Mike is a huge advocate of the growth mindset and that trading is a performance activity. It's performance driven. And we're going to talk about some of the steps that he went over in his interview regarding what they do to help traders work to the seven-figure trader level. And the big thing to understand about trading, we talk about this in the seven-step daily routine. If you haven't done so, go to my homepage, download it. It's an audio file. It's about creating the daily habits and rituals that will align you with what we're going to talk about today and ritualizing those little daily disciplines that pay big dividends, but also making them congruent with actually producing the results that you're after. So not just necessarily having a routine. Everybody already has a routine, but it's whether or not it's actually performance driven. And so one of the things that Mike talks about, there's four levels of traders that they look at, and consistency is the first level that they try to get most traders at. So most traders come to SMB, they have different ideas and perhaps perceptions of where they're at in their trading, but the first level for Mike is that they look to build consistency. And one of the ways they do that is to look at building your playbook with your best trading setups. Now those best trade setups are based on you and what you bring to the market in terms of your beliefs or your best skill sets, your ability to execute, where you see your edges. Again, they talk about taking traders, training them all the same way, and then each one of them personalizes their own trading approach. So it's really critical, and we've talked about this in other videos, that you build a playbook of your best trading setups. Now, I've talked about having one or two really simple setups. And again, as you go down further down the rabbit hole, if you have too many variables into your decision-making process regarding execution, you know, the more complicated things become, the harder it is to get consistency in your trading routine. And so one of my best playbook setups is all based around the Asia closed, London open. So I look for rectangles. I look for certain setups based on the close and the open of London. And then one of the biggest things that I love about that particular setup for me is that I know it's at a certain time every single day. And so that's one of the things that I could build into my routine for consistency. But again, building your own playbook of best trade setups is critical. And why that is because then you have something that you can go back to. And then the next part of that is the daily report card. So they talked about working with Brett Steenbarger, who is a trading psychologist and performance psychologist. And they developed the daily trading or the daily report card to help traders, again, constantly push the edge. So they would review what their preparation was for the day in terms of what they saw as their best opportunities in terms of their instrument, and then reviewed how they managed or how that process evolved over the trading day, what they did well, what they saw, what they could have done better. And again, the idea is just constantly tweaking and finding out where you could have done better. Because again, if you're not archiving that and journaling it, it becomes a forgotten memory. But one of the other things they talked about with the daily report card is they choose one goal every month and they focus their intensity on achieving that goal. So it might be to become better at losing, or it might be to become better at hitting the entries, whatever that goal is. But they focus in on that one goal for that entire month or the 30 days or whatever it is that you want to work on. And they really hammer down on that. And they focus on that with their trading, their best trading setups. And then they journal it, they do a daily report card, How did you do? What could you have done better? And the idea, again, is it's performance driven. So the more you can keep improving on your performance, hopefully your results are going to show that. So another component of that is designing your best daily routine. So we've talked about this in other videos. We talk about this in the 7-step daily routine. It's about shaping that around what is your ideal day, what's going to get you at your best for when you're there at the screen. And that goes right back down to, like for me, I talk about getting up in the morning, I talk about exercising, I get out the door, I have my headphones on. I like to exercise first thing in the morning. I know if I leave it to later in the day, the day can get away from me. But for me, that's what sets the tone for my day. I like to tidy up whatever things are in the house, do laundry, whatever, clean up, get my kids' rooms organized. And part of that is because I like a tidy environment. I like to start the day with a job well done and move on to the next task. I like to physically feel good. I don't tend to eat in the mornings. I usually fast for the first half of the day. I like to have a run before I'm at the screen. But again, I go through my own routine. I review my best trading book playbook setups. I archive any trades or notes from the day before and do screenshots. I put that into my playbook. I always, every single day, either listen to something, and it could be a short 5-6 minute video. I might review an old podcast. I like to watch Peter Brandt's interviews sometimes, or review some of Peter Brandt's charts. And again, some of the books, I might just skim a paragraph from Peter Brandt's book or One Good Trade. I love Kindle eBooks now. I've got those because I can take them on my phone anywhere. And I'm listening to an awesome audiobook by Grant Cardone called 10X. And the idea, again, just constantly raising the bar on not only what we can do in our trading, but all the way around, because I know that it reflects on the other things. And like Mike Bellafori talks about, it's like sport. It's a performance activity. So if I'm underperforming, which, you know, I've had some challenges in the last couple of months, as I tried to go to size, I made some little errors, some things that psychologically have challenged me. But again, with underperformance, it's, you know, number one, taking responsibility for those decisions. So I made some blunders. I looked at, well, what led me to doing that? Was it something in my preparation over the day? Was it something in terms of not, you know, having a clear headspace? We'll talk about mental preparation in one of our next few videos. What are the reasons why? And then take steps to get better. Again, we want to minimize underperformance things and maximize performance drivers. So again, in the 7-step daily routine, I talk about mindset being probably the most critical factor. You know, they talk about trading psychology and all these other things. The key component of the psychology in terms of mindset training and everything else is about shifting your energy from the things that you don't want and keeping it focused on what's actually going to produce your results. You know, I talk about, I don't watch the news, I don't read the newspaper, I don't watch CNN or business channels or anything else. I don't care about any of that. What I'm actually concerned about is the implementation and execution of trading my edge. And if there's any flaws in that, you know, again, every single day the market presents the information to us in various ways. It never comes in the same way twice. It'll come in morphs of the same sort of patterns and those different types of things. So it's critical that we're constantly training ourselves to recognize certain things, to be able to hit the trade when that trigger comes up, you know, to eliminate hope, fear, and greed out of the equation, have a process for managing our trades throughout the entire equation, extracting profit if you're in a profitable trade, you know, maximizing hopefully the maximum amount out of that trade as possible. And if you're going to take a loss on that trade, making sure it's the smallest loss possible that you can do. So again, just some different resources for daily mindset training. Consistently profitable traders are all built around performance drivers. And that's performance, not so much in you can't control the outcome, but you can control everything else about your trading process. So hopefully you got some value from today's video, traders. Again, some sample resources, performance drivers, underperformance, taking responsibility, assessing why that may have happened. And again, working in the direction of constant progress. And again, like Mike talked about, how good can we get as traders? So stay focused, stay disciplined, and may the markets go with you. Hi traders, it's Stacey Burke from Stacey Burke Trading. If you haven't done so, please head over to my website at staceyburketrading.com. I create updates on almost a daily basis, and I would love for you to receive them. Just click on the blog.
If you want to enter your name and your email address, I'll send you my free audio program, The 7-Step Daily Routine for High Performance Traders. This is essential knowledge for all traders in all markets, and this is for helping traders to master the market with discipline, confidence, and a winning mindset. I appreciate all your feedback and comments. As always, traders, stay disciplined, and may the markets go with you.